Namaskaram, Ashok Vyas. And today I have extra joy for being able to talk to someone who has shared her inner richness with grace and blessings in a way which is unique, and that led her to the president's house. After, of course, many years of continuous service, what she has done, why she chose to stay back in India and didn't feel like coming to America after finishing her medical studies, when a lot of her colleagues or fellow students were migrating from India to America. There is so much about her humility and unassuming approach which makes you try to discover what lies behind Dr. Sai Lakshmi, founder of Ekam Foundation. Sai ji, namaste. Swagat hai aapka. So we don't talk about what you have done, what you have not done. Let's talk about your smile and laughter, which is your constant companion, where it comes from.
It comes out of the joy and happiness which has been given to me by the grace of my guru, I would say. And as you rightly said, all of us have joined the medical school. Some of us have, some of us have moved to US, some are there. So every soul has a soul agenda. And I felt that the purpose of life I could understand by the grace of the guru, I felt, and thanks to him for being there. And I think that he is the source of the joy within me.
Okay, so let's now talk about guru, from smile to guru. What is it that you would say is distinct and special and significant about the relationship between a guru and a disciple, and being a doctor yourself, having studied medical science, I underline the word science, where do you see this invisible bond resulting into something which you say is the secret of your smile?
So my guru, Dr. Avadhoot Shivanand Babaji, he had come into my life in 2011 in the physical form, where I did the first Shivir. It's part of Shiv Yoga. He's the founder of Shiv Yoga. And that's when I understood that gurus come in our lives way before even we meet them in the physical form. So that's how that made me gave me the feeling that Ekam got started as an offering to him.
Which
and
year?
In 2009 started.
Yeah, but that's what I was thinking. He wasn't present in your life in physical form, but you founded Ekam. So I'll come back to Guru Shishya, and especially what you learned from your guru. Let's go to the root of your name. So Sai of Shirdi Baba, or Puttuparthi Satya Sai Baba, is your name somewhere coming from that, with some family members' deep devotion?
Yes, my father and mother, they are strong devotees of Satya Sai Baba, and so that's how the name came.
And so Sai Lakshmi, now we come back to Guru. Guru is also a source of power and inspiration and guidance only when you let that happen. So how this played out in your life?
I think it's a beautiful journey. The moment that connection happens, it's like, there's somebody to take care of. So it becomes a joyride. The moment you feel that, it's like we are like a child in the hands of a parent. So Babaji means he's like a father to us. Anytime, any difficulty, you just ask, he's there to sort out. That's the beauty of a guru. And for me, he's like the godly presence, like the omnipresent phenomena, what we call. I call Babaji as a phenomena. He's an omnipresent phenomena for me. So that's how the moment you give in and you feel that there's somebody to take care of, so and you are totally secure, and whatever happens, whether at that moment it could be something very bad, but when we believe that it is for a higher purpose and it gets taken care of, then you don't sort of have any, you know, feeling. That's the thing which Babaji has given to me, like, you know, he's there to take care of, so don't worry.
So don't worry, but you were worrying while you were finding a frustrating feeling because you couldn't treat your patients, especially being a pediatrician.
Yes.
You were finding you have certain limitations in terms of the way you can offer them the cure, either because of lack of proper resources, monetary resources, or proper equipment, or you needed them to go through certain tests which they couldn't afford. So how was that phase for you?
Yeah, so nice that you have asked this, because in 2009 when Ekam got started, because of this frustration and anger that the children were actually sort of dying because of, you know, there is a huge discrepancy in the supply and demand in the public healthcare system in India. At that time, I didn't realize that there was so much of anger going within me and the frustration going. And then Ekam got started to do something. And then in 2011, I sort of got diagnosed to have breast cancer followed by spinal metastasis. And then that was when one of my friends said, like, you know, why don't we do something like pranic healing? And later on, I was actually wanting to explore certain meditation processes, and that was when my sister was searching for something like healing, and that was then she found Babaji for me. And that was a time when somebody was healing me. They said that you have so much of anger within you. Till then I didn't know that so much of anger was there within me, or frustration was there. And then when I started doing these meditation, Shiva Yoga meditation, and I started, everything was happening, and it was like, you know, in 6 months time after doing my Shivir, and then I was religiously doing the Shiva Yoga healing meditations, and then in 6 months time it was like, you know, the PET scan completely reversed and showed normal. During this period there was a lot of introspection going on, like, you know, the moment there is the anger part, that means, like, you know, there is an ego within us saying that I am doing it, to sort of giving in and there is somebody else doing it, made the difference. And that's where you see from an anger person to person who sees that this is part of it. Life is like, you know, you see difficult situations and you are the karta bhav when it comes. That's what my guru says, when you go into the karta bhav, then we are gone, you know. So that's what it is like. That's the beautiful guidance when we get from the guru, that it is not the karta bhav, just be an instrument and enjoy this as a part of being an instrument has brought in that transformation, I would say.
So when you listen to Sai and you start thinking about this step, that step, so I'll go to this step. When I said this step, meaning you are a doctor yourself. You know how biological system works much more than a lot of people, including me. So how did you explain to yourself that there was a breast cancer and without any external allopathic treatment it got cured, and you did the test again and it was not there? How do you explain that?
Okay, so first I would like to correct that I went through the regular treatments, like, you know, whatever the chemo, radiation and surgery as a part of the breast cancer, and the spinal metastasis where the radiation treatment. But simple things like bone metastasis, when it happens, they are extremely painful. But what would happen is, when I was getting little bit of pain, I would ask one of my friend to start healing, or I would do the practices which I learned from Babaji, and immediately the pain would go off. So then I was very excited. I, like, you know, I would have taken very, very, very minimal painkillers. And then I could see that how fast the recovery was happening, like, be it my activity wise or whatever. It was like, you know, I mean, never I was so tired that I was actually sort of, during the treatments, maybe few days I would feel like that. But otherwise, the recovery was very fast. And many a times when I was with my co-patients going to the radiotherapy, I would listen like they would have got so many side effects because of those medicines which they had taken. So then I would think, okay, this would have been the side effect, or this is the side effect I would have actually sort of understood from them. So it went off like a joyride, you know. Though I was going through the treatment, never would I feel that pain, and the recovery was very fast and it reversed. And now I'm not on any other further medication past 5 years, and continuing my sadhana. And like, you know, my guru says, like, cure is possible. And it has to be integrative to start with, in the sense, like, you know, we need to integrate it with allopathy, but cure is possible. So,
okay, so now let me ask you, of course, you must have learned from your guru as well as something in you. Many times when things are not favorable and what you have been through, physically challenging, experiencing that which is not pleasing, many times puts people in that mental state where they start questioning, they have a lot of anger within, as you were earlier mentioning, and whatever it is, they find certain equilibrium, yet they don't have enthusiasm of the kind that you have demonstrated through Ekam Foundation in treating or extending helping hand to so many people. So where is the secret for this joyful enthusiasm to reach out and help?
Okay, so it was, I always felt it was a blessing in disguise, and never I felt that I was going to die, but I had got lot of time to work for the cause. And in fact, because of the time which I have got, I could actually send mails to my friends and whoever were there, like, here are a kids who are there and they need funding support. And it was also a sort of an emotional blackmail, in the sense, like, they were so that helped on a lighter side. But definitely it gave me a lot of time for myself to actually give to Ekam, so that the work progressed much more than what it has been. And so that helped a lot, in the sense, you know. And many a times there was no plan as such, you know, to do, but the direction used to come and used to move in the direction. Started off initially like a charity mode, but it got transformed into a completely, systemic change model. It all evolved. As a doctor, I typically did not know all these things, but not planned. It just happened on its own. So I always feel that the divine grace showed the direction, and I just moved in that direction.
Okay, now moving with you in that direction, Ekam Foundation came into being, and it has grown, and it has grown to the extent that the impact of Ekam Foundation was noticed by Government of India, and you have worked in partnership with Government of India, and government also awarded Nari Shakti Puraskar to you. So talk to me about how it happened that a small organization, comparatively with limited resources like Ekam Foundation, started partnering with Government of India.
Yeah, so initially we started working in 2009. It was like, you know, working with the orphanages, then trying to see how best the caretakers of the orphanages could get trained, so that they actually, you know, refer these babies in the right time to the right center, then providing them with the hospitalization support and also doctor's support, and also few donors who would actually support. And slowly we moved on to see that we work with the corporation schools, Anganwadi centers, and this journey made us understand that we need to empower a system rather than creating dependency. And then we started working with the government hospitals, and obviously, you know, there is so much of a supply and demand discrepancy, and like children needing medicine support, and sometimes if they're not available, or sometimes they would need small equipments which could cost $5, which are not available, and you know, we sort of lose these kids. And that was when we started approaching various donors and who would actually if they could come and support. And that was the time we would be asked, like, you know, why government hospitals, like what's happening to the funding which the government has. And as we all know, the GDP allocated to the health sector is very less, like, you know, it is 3, it is 4 right now, as compared to the GDP in US it is 14. So the budget allocated is less compared, very much compared. So when we started working with the government system, we realized that if we can complement a system which is already existing, and not like having a parallel system, constructing hospitals and, you know, so much of resources are needed for that, there would be, like, you know, the resources would be used in a very judicious way compared to what if we do as a parallel system.
Let me understand. One, you are functioning mainly in Hyderabad?
In Chennai, Tamil Nadu to start with, but we are working in 5 states currently.
Okay, so those who are potential beneficiary of the help extended by Ekam Foundation, how they reach out to you,
yeah,
and in what situation someone should look up to Ekam?
Yeah, so we have a helpline, and the helpline, the community, anybody can call up to the helpline, and the helpline team sort of validates their economic status and what is their current situation, and based on that we actually, you know, see that they would be sent to the right center, be it a government hospital or a private care. And we have in 32 districts of Tamil Nadu, we have 32 district offices. Their main role is they go to the rural areas and create the awareness of the helpline, start doing a lot of training and educational programs, and then identify the kids who are needing the most. Like, we also work with almost 13 government departments, and we reach out to them, like a primary healthcare center, the school department, the Anganwadi department, the labor department. So basically these centers are there in the villages. These district officers approach them through these centers. So we sort of utilize the manpower of the government too, and create the awareness, identify these kids, and then see that they go to the right center in the right time, and follow them up once they get discharged. So that's how this whole model works.
Okay, so people who need help now have an additional way to get this 5 lakh, up to 5 lakh rupees.
Yes,
Ayushman Bharat.
Yeah.
So has that been a help for people that Ekam Foundation is working with?
So that is not yet fully implemented in the states. It's going to come, but that would be a great help for patients who are in need. And definitely now, right now, we utilize the government health insurance schemes which are existing right now. And in fact, almost last year we had got 120 kids, their cardiac surgeries done completely from the government insurance scheme funding. So our main role is to identify the kids, make them aware that they are parents, that they are entitled for this funds, and these hospitals are empaneled and see that they go there. Sometimes, you know, because of the package, if it is less than what the private hospitals are overspending, then they would sort of refuse. Then what we do is we bring in private donors funding also, so that it complements the government insurance scheme funding, and over and above we supplement it with the donors funding. So, but we utilize government funding to the maximum extent. So
I'm talking to Dr. Sai Lakshmi, founder of Ekam Foundation, and she has helped save lives of over 12,000 kids, as I read somewhere. There are various ways in which Ekam Foundation is reaching out with help where it is needed. That includes training also.
Yes.
Training the hospital staff?
Training, yes. We have recruited almost 3,000 nurses. It has been outsourced to us and completely funded by the government. But we recruited and we sort of facilitated the training for the government so that they sort of give quality care. And we have also come up with something called Mentor Nurses Training Program, where we sort of build the mentor nurses and who in turn do the training to the nurses who are hands-on. And we also do the community training programs, where we build community health volunteers who have the knowledge on maternal and child health care, and they are sort of like barefoot doctors in the community. They are there all the time in the village, and they would be the first responders, so that any mother who is in need, like a 10th or 12th standard passed women, would be trained on, like, if you have a baby with jaundice, you just refer the child, or if you have a baby whose breathing rate is fast, more than 60 in a minute, you refer. So there is a training protocol which is there for the community based volunteers, and they would learn that, and based on that they would actually guide the mothers to refer the babies early, and in that way they sort of refer them early and they get the treatment earlier.
So as you listen to Dr. Sai, it becomes clear that in addition to being a physician with that knowledge, the work that you are doing involves a lot of managerial ability. Yes. And probably it is a different kind of a skill set that is needed in order to be able to manage operations of this kind at this level, where you are dealing with, of course, a lot of doctors, other volunteers, and you need to have good people who are ultimately reaching out in the name of Ekam in the villages, etc. So how do you overview your operations so that it doesn't go haywire?
Yeah, so we have come up with something called a group governance model, where it's like a circular non-hierarchical model at the senior level, and the team actually sort of governs, and we have a proper systems and processes in place, and then that monitors, like, these all 33 district officers have a zonal managers, then there's a state program manager, then we have the rest of the team, the group governance team, who actually sort of manage, and there is a board of trustees who oversee. And then at the grassroots level, we are trying to build the same model. There is something called Village Health Water Sanitation Committees, which all over India, they have been established, but they are not functional. So, none of them know that they are the members of these committees. It's a beautiful model, in fact. So we are trying to augment that model by bringing in this group governance. So we felt that we first need to experience that before bringing it at the community level, and we are sort of taking up one block per district in 32 districts of Tamil Nadu, and we are sort of implementing it. And to oversee this, there would be a block team and a district level team, then a state team. So that's what we are trying to build, but we realize that bringing volunteers is the biggest challenge. And initially we started that, but it used to fizzle out. So what we are now come up with a model called Sustainable Wellbeing Initiative, where this governance at the local level would be incentivized through various ways. One would be like a livelihood, where they would be getting more opportunities of livelihood if they take care of healthcare activities. So their performance indicator would be more on the healthcare side, so that they would get incentivized on the livelihood. Or there could be some material benefits that they could have got, or appreciating them. In fact, appreciating them in front of a collector or a panchayat president or somebody higher, they feel so proud for taking care of the health of the community. So these are the ways we are trying to bring in to empower them to feel that this is my village or my district, and I will take care of the health of my area, and to feel proud of
it. So Dr. Sai, listening to you tells me that somewhere there has to be a leader in someone who wants to reach out and serve, and leadership is of different kind. Corporate leaders are different. Spiritual leaders are different, as your Guruji, and political leaders are different. So, but what you are doing, it can easily move towards becoming a political leader. Have you ever thought, because if you are doing so much good work, and if you contest election, then
Ekam for me is a completely spiritual journey, and I'm experiencing the oneness. So that's what is giving me the absolute happiness, and that's really beautiful. And just to experience, to be an instrument in this journey, something what is making, giving me the happiness.
Talking about your interaction with Prime Minister Narendra Modi on informal level, was there some meaningful exchange of any idea when after Nari Shakti Award, you were invited to his home, and I think a group of awardees were there?
Yeah, it was a beautiful experience. We all shared our ideas to Modi ji, and he was very happy to listen to all the ideas and the vision we had. And in fact, he had connected us to the Prime Minister office and to the Health Secretary of the country to approach them and sort of see how best we can sort of take it to different states in the country. So that was a nice meeting, the PM, and in the PM office also they had mentioned like whatever support needed to they would offer us.
So now that we have Prime Minister Narendra Modi back in office of Prime Minister, leading the nation, based on your experience in the rural area as well as in the field of medical facilities which are available, what is the potential advice you may want to share with him?
That's a very interesting question, and giving more opportunities for organizations like Ekam across as a public-private partnership models. The biggest challenge we are finding is the behavioral transformation across. And we have this technical model which is sort of cracked in the facility side, where we actually sort of staffing, training and equipment maintenance and behavioral transformation, and we have a model here on the community side. And if this technical knowledge can actually be taken to different states, it covers like complete end to end, at individual, at the rural area to the facility level, and more on the prevention. This also covers the preventive aspect. And if this model, if we are given an opportunity to actually take this to different states, that would be a wonderful opportunity, I think.
Wonderful, and we almost are at the point where we'll be thanking you. But I also want to give you an opportunity for 30 seconds to thank those who also have founded the extension of Ekam Foundation as Ekam USA, and anything about them.
Yeah. So in 2016, Dr. Neelima, she is my medical school friend, and Dr. Shilpa, both of them are medical school friends, and Aruna, they have started Ekam USA, and it is a 5013 certified organization. And in fact, I was just saying that in the medical college time, I was just mentioning like, they were coming to US, and I was saying like I would stay back, and telling them that, after many years, if something I would do, you support, and that's what is happening. They are coming back and supporting, and all the medical school friends, college friends, everybody is joining hands, and we have sort of set up chapters, 20 chapters across US. And Neelima is putting amazing energy and efforts into it. And each chapter is sort of adopting one district in Tamil Nadu to start with, to understand the deeper dynamics of maternal and child healthcare, and they would actually manage it hands-on. It's like a project management for them. It's not like writing check and closing it. So that's where every chapter would understand in a deeper way. So we are trying to build individuals who are hands-on and understand the model in a deeper way in United States here, so that they actually get connected to others and sort of take this forward. And the other thing, we are also working in the youth. So with the youth, we have started youth ambassador program here. The idea is how best we build in values in youth, and they get connected to the roots. That's the idea, and that's coming up beautifully. A lot of youth ambassadors are coming forward.
Wonderful. Yeah. So Dr. Sai Lakshmi, founder of Ekam Foundation, is not only serving in the areas which are specified in terms of child care training for the hospital staff, also coming up with the kind of help in terms of diagnosis, tests, etc., or equipments, etc. But there is deeper work on value system, not only in India, but here also, and it's like sun spreading its rays everywhere and brightening up the whole world. So oneness lightens up and brightens up with lots of congratulations and good wishes to you, and thank you very much for joining us here. If you want to find out more about Ekam, of course Ekam Foundation has its website, which is very easy to find if you Google or YouTube. But how would you say ekamfoundation.org?
It is ekamusa.org and ekamoneness.org.
Wonderful. So on that note, stay healthy, happy, and stay in tune to oneness. This is Ashok. Yes.